Secretary Dr. Fred Matiang'i is now addressing Parliamentary Committee on Security in the coastal city of Mombasa. Let's listen in.
Can get to know one another as a family or a community of security sector players, but also so that we can share with you some of our plans, some of the things we are doing, and we can also benefit especially from you on your perspectives, your expectations of us, your experiences in Parliament, because you are the representatives of the people that we work for. And therefore, Mr. Chairman, I'll be the first one to request that when it comes to the plenary session, I am enthusiastic to hear from the Honourable Members of Parliament their suggestions, their views on a number of things that we are doing, some of which I'm going to talk about just now. Before I go very far, Mr. Chairman, please allow me to introduce about four critical people. I know everyone was asked to stand, but I consider these four to be very important. Mr. Joseph Boynet is our Inspector General of Police, and you know him here. He's a guy who's blamed for many things, but I can tell you he's a guy who has one of the toughest jobs in the country, but someone I am grateful to work with, and I think Kenyans should support for the great work that he does. You'll come to know him, and you'll come to interact with him, and you will know that we have in him a very strong, focused Inspector General of our police service. Mr. Edward Njoroge Mbogwa, our new Deputy Inspector General in charge of the police service. I think this is his first interaction with the Honourable Members of Parliament. I guess you'll get to know him. I need to say he's a very experienced police officer, probably one of the most experienced police officers in the service right now, who has served across the country, held very many responsibilities. And Honourable Members, it's important to say this, that in some of the things we do, when you come across police officers, such as Mr. Mbowa is going to tell you, who have served in various areas, they have been at the airport, they have been at our ports of entry, they have been OCSs and OSBDs, and they have served in various parts of the country. So they have a very serious knowledge of the country in some of the things and decisions that they make, and we're grateful because Mr. Mbowa is such officer. Mr. Noor Gabo, our Deputy Inspector General, in charge of the Administration Police Service. You will come to know, and I think it's important I tell you, that Mr. Gabo is one of our police officers who has got an international police service experience, who has served on international missions, and we are very grateful. Personally, I'm grateful for the decision that the President took to appoint Mr. Gabo our Deputy Inspector General, especially because of that. Because some of the issues that we're dealing with are now requiring a very broad and open approach. And Mr. Gabo brings such experience to us. Mr. George Kinoti, our new Director of Criminal Investigations. Again, this is his first meeting with you. He was appointed recently. He's one of the new officers. I can tell you this without a doubt, that I personally feel some change in the manner in which we are moving forward with criminal investigations work. And the Honourable Members of Parliament, you will see it, you will feel it as we move forward, because our new DCI is not only an old hand in this, but he too brings fresh blood, wealth of experience in the things we are doing, and we are very grateful that we have him. I would like you to know these four people, interact with them, Honourable Members, as we go along. I know, and I'm sure this is going to be raised when we start the plenary discussion, we have many issues to deal with. We are ready. We don't shy away from challenge. We are ready to deal with the challenges that we face, and I'm very grateful to these people. I saw Mr. Isaiah Osugo, our Commissioner General of the National Prison Service. Mr. Isaiah Osugo is there. Mr. Osugo, too, is a very experienced officer who has actually spent the entire of his career in the security sector. And the difference he proceeds or brings is that he has been in the police service. He has worked with the criminal investigations, and now he's the head of our national prisons service. So he understands the spectrum of security responsibilities, as it were. It has been very easy to work with him on the very radical reforms we're interested in the national correction services because of the experience he has. And when you get to know some of the officers he's working with, he has got probably one of the most experienced team of former national government administrators, you know, working with him. He has two of our former provincial commissioners who work with him, very experienced people, and we are grateful that we have this team that works with us. I know the PS will introduce some of my most favorite people later on, who are our regional commissioners, who carry our burdens when we are seated in our offices in Nairobi. The field is managed by 8 regional commissioners, and when the PS introduces them, you will also see the wealth of experience we have in the people who are our regional commissioners, because they are people, all of them are people who have grown through the ranks, from serving in sub-counties all the way up, and in across, you know, various parts of the country, and therefore they bring the knowledge that we need and the experience we need to move forward. Honourable members, this is what we agreed, the PSS and myself. I'll make an overview presentation. I'll touch on a few issues. But my 3 PSS will drill down to the specifics in each of the departments. I have elected to focus more on what I consider to be urgent, important, and current things that you need to know as members of Parliament, so that even as you legislate, and even as you are looking at oversighting our sector, frankly speaking, some of the things I want to point out to you are like the things that should be on top of your mind as you move around. And as our interactions go on, when we will be having the privilege to serve our country, you will notice that most of the issues revolve around some of the things I'm going to raise this morning. And my colleagues, the PSS, will now drill down to the specifics in each of the state departments. And then thereafter, during the plenary discussion, we'll all be, you know, willing, ready, and available. All our heads of department are here. All our heads of agencies are here to answer or respond to any issue that you may have, any concern that you want us to address. And we are all willing to take all your advice on what you think we need to do differently and how we can improve the security of the country. I am always advised by my colleagues in the Ministry of Interior, led by P.S. Kibicho, that as the Minister for Interior and Coordination of National Government, my first responsibility when I make a public appearance is to say this that I'm going to tell you. I can assure you that our country is safe, our country is secure. I get reports every morning from 4 a.m. in the morning. I have gotten reports from all the regional commissioners in the country, and save for the challenges we have with flooding in about 3 or 4 parts of the country, and a few penal code challenges across the country, our country is secure. We don't have any major challenge that we can worry about. And to that, we need to thank our men and women in uniform who spent their time out there doing a lot of work. Our men and
Well, if you're just joining us, those are live pictures coming our way from Mombasa, where the Interior Cabinet Secretary Fred Matiang'i is at this moment addressing members of the parliamentary security.